Okay, everybody can hear me. Yeah, hi, my name is Frank, and I'm happy to be here and talk a bit about coherence. Who in the audience knows about DLNA or UPnP a little bit? Okay. UPnP is a protocol to let devices find itself on the network. So it stands for Universal Plug and Play. It is the network analog onto plug and play, put some hardware into a PC, and it just finds that the hardware is where. And UPnP is the same on the network. DLNA is a specification on top of that. It clarifies a lot of things that are left over in UPnP, but I won't go too much into the details. I talked today about a special part of UPnP, UPnP audio and video. There are other things in UPnP, but as I said, today we talk about that part of the family, and especially from the application developer point of view, because we added a few weeks ago the gluing part to Rhythmbox to enable UPnP support in Rhythmbox. And yeah, the talk is about opening the Rhythmbox. What do I need to do? Ah, okay. Anybody in the room remember these kind of things? That was part of my music collection in the end of the 70s, beginning of the 80s. 10 years later, it looked a bit like that. A lot more, but actually I haven't found all these CDs anymore. Again, 15 years later, no, there's one page missing. Ah, it's doing something. Again, what you don't see here are two iPods. You know them. Now you don't have your music, your audio on CD or on records. You now have them on the iPods. And actually, now when you deal with digital media, we now talk about audio, but it can be video or images, whatever. And you want to distribute them into your home, you can put it on a hard disk, on a network attached storage, and serve it, stream it to UPnP clients. Something like the Xbox over here, Philips Streamium System, TerraTech Noxon. There are a lot of more. But that is a little bit, cumbersome. Because actually, you don't want to put your media into a file system and put on directories, arrange the thing in directories. That's not the way you organize your data. Think about, you have a media center application, like Eliza. You have your musical data sorted by artists, you have albums, you have your playlist, your favorites. Same over in Rhythmbox. You do exactly the same. And just to serve the data onto your network, it doesn't make sense to replicate the same thing into a UPnP server. So the idea is add the functionality to the application and let the application do all the tagging, all the sorting, and let the UPnP stuff do the distribution in the network. So what we can do now, we can stream data between Rhythmbox and Eliza, for example. We can do the same to the PlayStation 3. We have a Nokia controller system, and we can, from the Nokia, control Rhythmbox and say, yeah, use that file, play it, stop, change the volume, all based on a ISO standard. Not something we just defined for that special purpose. It's based on a UPnP standard called Media Renderer Control. And of course, we can stream from Eliza to our Nokia when we are in the garden or something else, somewhere else. And a nice feature, we can store something that's on the N800 or on our UPnP-enabled phone. When we come back home, we can store it into our media center. It's a feature of UPnP. Currents, that's the framework. It's just, depends on how you look at it. It can be a standalone system. It can be embedded in other applications. Or it can be a server that you talk to via remote procedure calls, DBus, and ask it to announce whatever services you have onto the network. And a very important thing I want to stress here, UPnP is not only about one part of a family, the internet gateway device, that is mostly well known about its security issues. There's a lot more with UPnP and a lot more family members. And we are talking about UPnP audio video now. In that specifications, we have three devices. We have the media server. Media server just stores your files. It can organize playlists, text, artists, whatever. We have media renderer. Now, one thing I forgot, always a media server can, with a newer specification, do recording and propagate electronic programming guides too. Media renderers, something that displays an image, LCD screen on your wall, a TV with a built-in media renderer to play back video or something that plays back audio. The thing that interconnects these two devices are control points. They are there to provide information what you have on the media server, what media servers are on your network, and you can tell with the control point the media renderer to play that file from that media server, that playlist on that media renderer. And it provides some information about what your kids are listening to in their living room. So the features we have there, we have media sharing, of course, that's the easiest thing. We have recording. We can tell the media server, please record, if it's capable of that, please record that DVD stream or something else at that time. We have playback and controlling. We have organizing, playlists, artist folders, album folders, and we have the possibility to exchange media data between devices, move some files from one media store to the other media store. Now, let's go to Ribbonbox. What we've added to Ribbonbox are these three key features. It's now able to access other UPnP media servers on the network. That sounds pretty easy. It's a little bit more complicated under the hood, but that's what CoreRent is for. It can export its media data to other UPnP players, the things I told you before, PS3, Xbox, something like that. And we can now control it from the Nokia, from any other commercially available UPnP control point. Again, let me emphasize on this. It's not needed to put something on these devices. If you have a UPnP control point on newer Nokia phones or on the Philips devices, it will be able to control now Ribbonbox. This is how the whole thing looks like. The whole thing here is CoreRent. It contains everything you needed or you need to speak to other UPnP devices. UPnP is very difficult set of protocols. We have multicast, UDP, we have SOAP, we have HTTP, and a very strange mixture of all these things. But from my point of view, an application normally doesn't have to know all these things about. It just says in Rhythmbox, I have some media data and I want to export it on the network. So what we need is a little bit of Clue code here that just translates the UPnP browse request into a request to get that data from the Rhythmbox database. Same over here for the Rhythmbox player. What we need is the Clue code that translates the play request from the UPnP control point into the play command that Rhythmbox actually makes playing the song. And on this thing here, Rhythmbox sends out, give me all the media files that are on the network, and we just return it, and Rhythmbox can display it in its UI. The whole thing, the whole Clue code is not more than 1,200 lines of Python code. Most of it really is just mapping, translating between the Rhythmbox database, Rhythmbox internal representation of an audio file into what UPnP thinks an audio file or the metadata for an audio file should look like. Go back one. These 1,200 lines are 400 here, 400 here, 200. I'm sorry. 400 here, 400 here, 200 here, and the rest is a little bit of initialization code to get the whole thing up. I'm so focused on this. So it's really pretty easy to add UPnP functionality to your application. What we discovered when working with Rhythmbox is an application that thinks, okay, I'm here, I'm sitting here, I have access to my media database, I'm a master, I'm always in control. But if you suddenly you get access from the outside of the world, there are some strange things happening. Rhythmbox, for example, accesses the album art only when it's playing the file. But a control point on the network wants to display that audio art when browsing the database. So this is something we need to change there. And media file data access is not transparent. For example, if you access your media data via Samba share, Rhythmbox does not provide that information for coherents to access it. So we need some fix for that. Yeah, that's my presentation. Thank you very much. If you want to know more about it, we have a track set up here. There's all the source code. A wiki, tickets, write anything you want about that. We hang most of the time on IRC, on the channel Currents. And would be happy, very happy to see you there. Any questions? Whoa. No one. Too complicated. As I said, Coherence is, look at it as a server. It just sits there, and you can connect to it with that Clue code here. You can embed Coherence. It's written in Python. So if you are a Python program, you just load Coherence into yourself and speak to it with that methods here. Rhythmbox just enables Python plugins, so we just load that little bit of Clue code, it loads Coherence, and that's it. Coherence can run standalone, so if you have more software that uses Coherence, it just makes sense to have it run standalone and let that Clue code act via dbus or via any RPC method.